Hey, welcome back to Kevin Wilson SBC. This is going to be part two of Phillip's back of the track, no prep, very heavy. I'm talking 4,100 pounds. Going out and with the full remote chassis suspension baseline, we've been working together now for quite a while. And Phillip went from a big tire to a small tire to compete more up in Canada on back of the track racing. Well, this is going to be a continuation from the other video. I will make sure that video is linked. I'm not going to rehash all of that, but this is after my recommendations when Phillip contacted me and went to a small tire. You can see he did some testing before we made some changes with a small tire, and it was definitely crushing the sidewall of the small tire slick. So with that situation, I had Phillip make some changes, and he went back out, and we're going to show some actual video. But what I'm getting ready to show you is Phillip had, two test sessions, and then they didn't have a huge car turnout, but Phillip wound up going four rounds. He went to the finals, and we're going to show some of these videos. And on the final race, Phillip forgot to arm his nitrous. So this is a big block Chevy guy, Chevy truck, and it has a couple stages of nitrous. I'll leave that up to Phillip to share more if he wants to. But on the last race, he more than had what he needed to take the win on this back of the track event, but he forgot to arm the nitrous, and he didn't win that final round. But we're going to show a couple videos. I'm going to explain some of the changes I had Phillip make in between rounds. So Phillip was actually sending me video content between rounds, and he had worked with me on working that situation out. And I would give him some recommendations on how to go back out and do the next round. And it led all the way up to Phillip running a personal best ever with the truck on a back of the track, no prep event. And this truck is moving the mail. So let's jump right in and talk about this from round to round. This video is gonna follow suit. I'm going to introduce what I'm doing now, and I'm gonna do some voiceovers with the videos that Phillip sent me. These aren't the highest quality videos. You gotta understand, these videos are being transferred back and forth over mobile media, and they get compressed quite a bit. I apologize about the quality, but they're good enough where you can see how the truck reacts and see how the truck gets down the track. So let's take a look at these videos, and I'll walk you through round by round. All right, just for a quick recap, this is the four-link plot of how the truck was set up when Phillip first engaged with me a while back, and this is on a big tire. And I want you to go back, and if you haven't watched the part one video of this yet, you definitely need to go watch the part one video, because we're not going to spend a lot of time here. Phillip has agreed to let me show you the plot that we went to for the big tire. Before I share the four link plot changes, let's go ahead and see how the truck responds and does at this back of the track event. And then I will share the four link plot after you see how the truck does. Huge shout out to this drag racing track. I would love to one day get up into the Atlantic Canada area. I have a lot of great customers from Canada, wonderful people, and huge shout out to this racetrack right here for putting on this event that Phillip was at this Saturday, back of the track. So let's go take a look at some videos from Phillip and see how the truck is responding. Let's slow this down a little bit and watch how much happier the car is with tubes. I did have him soften the rebound a couple clicks for this outing, but after watching this video and seeing a little bit of the porpoising, I did have Phillip tighten the top rebound or the rear rebound two more clicks
for the next outing. It's also important to remember that Philip is leaving in second gear with a turbo 400. So that's important to remember as well. So I had Philip tighten the rear rebound 2 clicks. Now let's see how the next run looked. Okay, slowing this down a little bit, let's watch how happy the truck is. Look at how it's not crushing the sidewall of the slick. It's smooth. It's bringing the front end up in smooth control, not jerky fashion, not bouncing around, carrying on. The tighter rear rebound also helped eliminate the porpoising. The truck is just so much happier. Look at this initial reaction on a back of the track. Look how the weight begins to transfer immediately. The front comes up, the rear is coming down. We're planting the slick, we're not crushing it, and the truck just so smoothly moves out. Let's take a quick look at the third video Philip sent me and see how the truck continues to do. Okay, slowing it down again, this truck is freaking working. As a matter of fact, Philip said this was his personal best on a no-prep, back-of-the-track surface ever with this setup. Now, after watching this setup and how hard this car was running, Philip told me he was going to be adding more power. So with that in mind, I wanted him to soften the rear compression 2 clicks, and I wanted him to tighten the front rebound 2 more clicks, because he's going to be getting after it in the next couple of rounds. Some important housekeeping notes here. I did not get all the videos from Philip on this day. He made another run after this run, which was the semifinals, and then he went to the final run. I'm getting ready to show you the race he did after the final. So Philip forgot to arm the nitrous for the final run, and because of that, he did lose the race. However, he was so freaking prepped about how well the truck was working, he wanted to get one more race in on the back of the track, and they let him, so that he can get a draggy of the truck with all the nitrous turned on and him not having to lift at all. And he went out and ran his personal best. So let's watch a video after Philip lost the finals, but of him having the nitrous turned on and him running a personal best. So here's where Philip makes his personal best ever. After losing the finals because he didn't arm his nitrous, he went out with his draggy. He wanted to make one more run with the shock changes we've already mentioned, and he was going to increase the power bring in all the kits of nitrous and not lift. This run, he went out, he did just that. He had two different camera angles. You can see the suspension working. He went out and laid down his personal best ever on the back of the track. I won't share his 60 foot or his ETs with you, but just know this 4,100 pound truck is hauling the mail with a big block Chevrolet, a couple kits of nitrous. This truck and Philip have been such a blessing to work with. As promised, here are the four link changes we made from this picture, which is how Philip came to me, to the four link changes we made with a 118 inch wheelbase on a big tire, and then how that transitions to a small tire. Thank you for sticking in here, and thank you to Philip for allowing me to show you these details. Just know there is so much more to getting this truck down the back of the track surface than just the four link plot. So much more is involved. Now, this is the four link plot that he had so much success with on the big tire 31 inch slick, and Philip really made huge improvements on his 60 foot and being able to not lift. All of this was covered in the part one video. I didn't share this four link plot, but now you can see the four link plot on the big tire. So how did this change going to the small tire? You can see no bar changes, but going from a 31 to a 28 inch small tire slick, you can see how the angles and everything changed. The four link plots are in the same holes as they were with the big tire, but now you can see that we're around a 44-45% anti-squat, 65 inches long, and this truck has a 118 inch wheelbase. That is so incredibly important. This first four link setup might have worked a little better with a lot shorter wheelbase. I'm talking like 100 to 104 inch wheelbase. But when you get out to 118 inch wheelbase, you really need to lengthen the instant center, lower it, and help get the weight from the front to the rear. Some key takeaways with this small tire four link plot. First of all, we had Philip go and put tubes in the 28 inch slicks. Anytime you are 3,000 pounds or over and you're running a small tire, absolutely, positively need to have tubes in the small tire slicks. You can notice the upper bar is still less than 10 degrees and the lower bar has a very slight downhill angle towards the chassis. It's important to understand these angles and the rear spread on the four link are critical on a wheelbase of 118 inches. And remember, this truck is 4,100 pounds. So going with the tubes and making some shock changes, we definitely improved the sidewall of the small tire slick.
I hope that made sense, guys. Thank you so much for hanging in there. I really enjoy these type of videos where I can show you real world customers whose cars are going out there and doing great. And Philip is actually doing very well with this truck and very knowledgeable. So it's always fun to work with a customer who is knowledgeable about their vehicle, who understands why we're making these changes. And Philip, thank you so much for the content and for working with me on letting me share your journey on this video. I just want to say this, guys. I wish I could devote attention to every piece of email and social media question that comes in. I'm just not able to do that. So I do give my attention to those who are purchasing the services. That's the only way I know how to be fair about it. And I make this content so that you can learn from it and you don't have to continually rely on someone else to set up your chassis. You can understand these changes. And let me just say this, in everything that I do, I'm always trying to do three things. I wanna go fast, I wanna go straight, and I wanna be safe. Good night, guys.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do